Okay, so for G5, R6, find a value using two variable equations. We're essentially combining the two different skills we've been practicing previously in this section. So this idea of recognizing that a letter represents or stands in for a number value, as well as solving for an unknown letter or value. So when I read the question here, the example says, use the equation V equals C plus 5 to find the value of V when C equals 6. So we already know the value of C, which is 6. So let's fill that in first. So we have V equals C plus 5. We know C equals 6. This actually becomes a very simple question. C equals 6 plus 5. Therefore, V must equal 11. A second similar example. Use the equation A equals 8H, or 8 times H. Remember, we talked about that's what that means, to find the value of A when H equals 5. So I write down the expression or the equation A equals 8H, which we can also just think of as, and I like to write it that way personally, 8 times H. Okay, so we know what H equals up here. 8 times H equals 5. So A, 8 times 5 is 40, equals 40. Simple as that. In this next example, we see there is a bit wordier, but the reality is they're just again trying to introduce you to this idea of what one of these equations could sort of represent. The real part that we need to focus on is this bit down here that looks like the other examples, but I'll read through anyway. Audrey uses 16 tomatoes to make each bowl of salad, letting S represent the number of bowls of salad. So we see our S in there. It's kind of hard for me to write. And T representing the total number of tomatoes she uses. So we're going to use the equation T equals 16S to find the value of T when S equals 2. So just relating it back to that sort of situation, they're saying for two bowls of salad, if we times that by 16, that tells us how many tomatoes she's going to need in total. So if we change the number of bowls of salad she wanted to make, if we change the value of S, it would tell us that we need more or less tomatoes. That's a way you can use these equations. But we're simply doing it where S equals 2. So T, be careful your T doesn't look too much like a plus sign. Mine kind of does there. Equals 16S, which again means 16 times S. We know what S stands for, 2. So T equals 16 times 2. Can't remember how to do 16 times 2. I'll just do it down here in the corner. 2 times 6 is 12. 2 down, 1 up. 1 times 2 is 2. Plus the 1 is 3. T equals 32. Okay, good luck.